In the olden times, a couple lived in the place called Tabiu. One day, the pair Magang-an and Kuya-ob found that their pig was nowhere to be found. They exerted all their efforts in looking for it, but they found no trace.
Ito pa'y natasan ni nung umiyan din ba, buita ko ay doy. Naikanaan anak tayan magamo.
Huwag man pa'y, ito pa'y natasan ni nung umiyan na baitit uwa.
After the several months, the hag came home. It seemed to be very tired and hungry. Too happy, they feed the pig and observed that its teeth were swollen. They suspected that it gave birth somewhere else.
Apay na ay kamanangayin manakot mo.
Nunay ang kayman mo. Ito pa'y natasa rin manakan di sana.
Kamayakan nga rod man alas ituyo. Tay pa'y kusin likod na tasapay mo nudun nuntos sa numyana.
Awkod nga rod ay ingkaman ala tay po'y mo.
Without the knowledge of the couple, the pig left hurriedly after eating its meal. As the pig mendered, the rice bran were falling.
Taong nulukot ka din na ito sa numyana.
Magang-an traced the pieces of rice bran scattered until he reached the gigantic tree in the place called Adaan. Under this tree, which is locally called a stool, were the mother pig and its piglets.
Nang sinako kay siruk ni kakulay-kawayin manak. Naimet kay man ay.
After he watched him, he wandered around the place and found out that there was abundant water, and the place was conducive for settlement and constructing rice and vegetables.
Ayun ay napinta sa sinasipan doon mo. Wala na numot mabalin ay manmula si pagoy yan at natang.
Magang-an go home and he told a story to his wife and her children. They decided to settle in the place where their pig gave birth.
Ito ko at ari dadaan ta distrito ko ay manto.
Awa rin si sana di kanam. Ito ko at ay sita ko at gawin manto.
His family requested their neighbors to help them transport their belongings to the new settlement. After some months, Kuya-ob was seriously ill. While tending to his wife daily, Magang-an observed many birds that came and ate the fruit of Tuo Tree. They produced too much noise that made the patient uneasy.
Kay man na nasibilit mo, nangalangodong, nai-disturbuhan daw sa mansak sakit ay.
One day, the husband got angry and he started to cut the trunk of the tree.
Taputukan na tanaysan mantutanot di bilik at pirmisan ngalaungaw da.
After he cut the trunk of the tuo tree, he was astonished to see that the trunk produced plenty of sap. Because Magang-an couldn't find any medicine for his wife, he experimented and made his wife drink the sap.
Ni reduot san danumnum. Kaman anak ko tadi sinas eksperimento tawara di may painom ko kan asawa.
After Magang-an daily gave it to his wife, Kuya-ob got well.
Mato pa din papainom mo kung sana ni. Ang ipapigsalat na inakaan ang sakit ko.
Due to the good story that was being circulated, some of the neighbors of Magang-an in Tabiu were encouraged to follow them to the new village.
Mayat sa lugar ay numienda Kuya-ob, ang takot at iabod sili.
Awari, hintakot ari garud abel.
The spot under the tuo tree became a resting, meeting and eating place of hunters and owners of cows from Kayan and Balawa, who tended their cows in Adaan due to the presence of abundant water. Moreover, the trunks of the tree were used for hanging or suspending the bags of hunters, water mills and some belongings were placed. Because the word tuo tree became very popular, as it was used daily in the villagers' daily activity, the place at Adaan was renamed Tuo.